Welcome back to interview series by Karshni Edited. Today we have Komal with us. Komal, we could begin with your brief introduction.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me to your channel, Simran. I'm Komal Singh. I'm currently pursuing BE in Electronics and Communication Department. My field of interest are networking, computer vision, machine learning, and I have done a couple of projects in the same, and also I have done few internships in the same. So that's about myself.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. So what are the primary resources and points that you followed for preparation?
Okay. So primary resources which I followed was basically from Geeks for Geeks for coding, and as well as taking like fundamental CS subject. You can say like DBMS, operating system, and object-oriented programming. And since I'm from electronics background, I did refer to such core subjects like digital electronics, analog electronics, and DSP from like my college notes. That was why like for the core preparation. Apart from the software, yeah.
So, in a gist, could you tell us about the overall structure of the placement process?
Yeah, so most of the company, they follow like three or four rounds of total, you can say. The first round basically is about the online test, which can be aptitude test, coding test. Again, it depends on the company. Like so many company will have online test that is based on some coding questions. Maybe MCQs or technical round, and some may have just test your skill based test, like for the technical subject. And the second round will be mostly technical, that is a interview round. And the third round can also be a technical interview round. And fourth round is definitely a HR and HM round, that is like no manager round kind of. That's the final round what company follows. Yeah.
So that brings us to your interview process. Could you talk about your interview and what was the most challenging round?
Yeah, so I had two technical rounds. So in that, the second round was difficult for me because they had asked me to code on the live editor, and they had told me to reduce the complexity of the code. That was one round which I faced a little bit problem. It's not because I could code, but for reducing the complexity and space complexity time. So that was the challenging round for my interview.
Yeah. Then it got cleared. So positive notes.
Yeah.
So yeah. Could you tell us about your coding round? Like how did you prepare for it?
Yeah. Coding round, I would say like since being from an EC background, I like for initially it was like this discomfort for me. I started in the sixth sem from Geeks for Geeks. I started with very basic questions for and you can say trees and that. That so goes on all the data structures and algorithm. I started with basic questions and then I moved on to little bit of lead code. That's how I like gained confidence. Initially, it was a bit difficult for me, but then I used to see the solution and then I used to understand the concept. And mostly, I can say programming is not about like following a pattern. It's about developing a logical thinking ability, I can say. So it's that's where it comes into picture. Programming is just not related to a domain like computer science. Any branch can any branch student can master it just by practicing it.
Yeah. Okay, right. So how important are the PGPA and projects? Like what would be the average weightage of the same in the procedure according to you?
Okay, so CGPA, I would say like that keeps you an upper edge from your other batchmates, I can say, in the case of eligibility criteria. And I don't think so it play a major role because most of the company prefer 7.5 as a decent CGPA. Like there were some companies in our college which came with 8 CGPA and above, but I would say that just maintain a decent CGPA above 7.5, that would be enough, I guess. And for projects comes into picture only when you clear the first round of your test, that is coding round or some aptitude round. For project, yeah, it do play a major role in your interview because, see, if you have done a good set of projects, your interview will be impressed by your project, and their questions will be revolving around those set of questions only. which you are very confident about what project you have done. So I would say the project plays a pretty good role in this part after your first round. Yeah.
Being placed, would you like to share your company and job profile?
Yeah, so I have been placed in this startup called Moondraft in Bangalore as a software development engineer.
All right. So what were the facts and myths that turned out to be true after the placement?
So myth, I would say, like, everyone used to say that CGPA plays a very major role in the placement process. But I would just say it's just an eligibility criteria. What matters is like how dedicatedly really you prepare in this placement season, and also facts like you should be very good at coding. Like I would say, if you really want a good job, you need to be good at coding, no matter what. Maybe a core company or a software company, both.
All right. Yeah. It's us to the concluding question. A few words of advice for the juniors.
So I would say, like, be consistent throughout your placement season. Like, don't be disheartened by if you have thought about, no, this company is for me, and if you don't get it in that, then please don't feel sad about. Like, keep preparing. And also, like, I have seen, like, people generally when they apply for companies, they do not look into job profiles and read about the company. So that is very important to read about the company, how, like, in which domain they work, and also the job profiles. So I would say, like, be office or office, please go through the job descriptions and about the company. Yeah, so that's.
So thank you so much for being here and giving your valuable experience with us.
Yeah, it was lovely talking to you, Simran. Yeah.
Thank you.